a Mongolian tradition that when you die, you will be reborn as a human. So I must study all I can, so when I die, I become a human. But for now, I'm just a trash can.
I did not think Art of the Racing in the Rain was trash. I just had a trash can, and I thought having a trash can views about being reborn as a human was funny. So it's not a bad movie. It's a fine movie. This was actually my first dog movie. Like, the dogs, I thought it was part of Dog's Purpose until I realized it was made by Starbucks. But you know what? I enjoyed it. It was 2 hours of my life that was enjoyable. I really wish the dog wasn't in this movie. Denny was an infinitely... His life sucks. Like, his life is awful. And we're just hearing about through the life of a dog, using about, like, the theory of gravity. And it's like, I'm a dog, but I just wanted to talk about, like, human things. And it's like, I don't care, dog. Enzo, you have a good voice, but, like, I don't care about you being a dog. Denny's life is so much cooler. Well, not cooler. His life sucks, but it'd be a cooler movie. Because in the span of the movie and the life of Enzo, he goes from losing his wife to, like, frame perfect, his wife's dad sues him for custody of the child because he's an asshole and is just a horrible person. And that's real bad. And then Denny, like, accidentally, like, pushes them, and he's like, "Oh!" He, like, hurts him. The grandfather, like, hurts himself, and you're like, "Okay." And then he files assault charges on him, and it's like, you don't get to see your kid, which is just cruel. And that dad is a horrible human being. Because Denny is now a single father who can't see his kid, who just loves his kid. But you know what? He can't see his kid because his wife's father is a horrible human being who, right after he just buried, and Denny buries his wife, he's like, "Ha, psych, you're going to not be able to see your daughter for 90 days. Which is like, that's a yikes for me, dog. Get a dog, because, you know, it's a dog movie. But I just don't understand why Enzo was the main thing here. I just want to see Denny struggling through life, because that man goes through all those things and somehow he's only depressed like 2 times. He's like fine, and you're like, this guy's a god. He's getting hit with like 4 different bullets that are all about to kill him, and he's like, I'm fine. He just watches a race, and he's like, I got this. We're good. And you're just like, this guy is... And he falls. Like, the only time Enzo does anything meaningful is at the end when he rips up the papers and is like, you're getting that get belt. You're not allowed to concede here. This is the only worthy thing Enzo did. But, you know, dogs are cute, and you want to sell movies based on them. But Starbucks made this movie, so I don't think they're actually going to be losing much of anything on this movie. Because it's Starbucks. They already have an audience. There's like a million white girls getting their coffee. And you just need somebody to make a film. Which is respectable. I'm glad you did that. But, like, what? I saw this movie was produced by Starbucks, and I was like, what? Why is it, what? It's like a little less weird than like if McDonald's made a movie. Because if McDonald's made a movie, I'd just be confused and like deeply disturbed. But Starbucks, you picked a decent movie. It wasn't like The Kitchen, which I've just heard nothing but bad things about. Or like half the movies that have come out this year that are just kind of eh. But you know what? You did a good. You made a fine movie. It's not the greatest thing I've ever seen. But you know what? It's real. It's fine. It's a fine movie. Would I recommend it? like 2 hours long, and it's about a dog in his life. But you go through his like whole life, so it's like 2 hours that actually is like 20 years. Because when he starts, it's just Enzo and Denny. And then it ends, and it's Denny and his kid, who's like basically an adult at this point. Like, the last scene where you see him, like, reborn is, like, or reborn, that's kind of, I don't like that. But his daughter's, like, looks like she's in her 20s or something. And it's like, oh, we've covered, like, 20 years in about 2 hours, which really doesn't work. Because you could have just made this movie about a doggy being supportive of his owner when his owner is going through a rough time, and start the movie when I'll introduce the wife a little bit, but then like end the movie after he gets his kid and he gets his kid back, because like that's all that really matters this movie. I don't care about Enzo dying and being rewarded as a human, because like what does that even mean? Like, I made the Mongolian thing as a joke skit, because I was like, this is so stupid. It's probably real. That's probably a legitimate thing Mongolians believed, but, like, looking at it now, I'm just like, that doesn't... Like, what? And I'm sorry if it's, like, an actual religion based on that. I don't... Is, like, Buddhism like that? Kind of. It's just kind of weird. Because he's like a dog being like, well, I gotta study up on being a human. Because if I want to be reborn as a human, I gotta know my stuff. Which is just like, what? That whole bit is like, I don't like that. Don't touch that. It's a can of worms that doesn't need to be opened. It's just kind of odd. But it's a good movie. It's a fine movie. It's a good 2 hours of my day spent watching a dog hallucinate a zebra. But it was actually just him ripping apart, like, stuff. And I was just kind of like, why is he hallucinating? Why is this zebra animated? So he's kind of weird. It's kind of strange. Like, I don't really... Like, the more I think about this movie, the more I'm like, what? I'm just, like, thinking, and it's like... This movie has a scene... where a dog is hallucinating a zebra ripping apart a stuffed animal. Like, what? And it ends with the dog implied to have been reborn as a little kid. And I just don't... Like, what? I'm having, like, a realization here. What's going on? I realize this movie is just kind of weird. But it's based off a book, apparently. I'm not going to read the book. I don't really care to read the book. It's just kind of... It's weird. I imagine if I dig into, like, the laws of whatever happened in this movie, in the whole Eve's dad, I remember her name, is just probably going to make this seem more questionable, but you know what? I enjoyed it. It wasn't the best movie I've ever seen, but it certainly wasn't the worst. I don't think it's in theaters anymore, or probably not in some of them, but if you like dogs hallucinating zebras ripping apart stuffed animals, go see this movie. Or if you like the dog's purpose movies, because apparently I have never actually seen one of those, but I'm just assuming that's what these are like. I don't really care for dogs. I just saw this because the week I was just trying to see something that week, and my other options were Dora, which I couldn't see by myself and feel like I had done something right, because I would have felt like very... Like, what am I doing? This is where I am in life, that I'm seeing a live-action Dora by myself. Or The Kitchen. which I just heard was awful. And I had already seen Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark, and that freaked me out, because I saw it at midnight, like you do. And I was not sleeping the rest of that night, so I said, I'm not going to see that movie again. So I saw The Art of Racing in the Rain.